In this lecture, we will discuss attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. ADHD, or attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, is sometimes also called ADD, or attention deficit disorder, when there is less hyperactivity. So there are really a few different types of ADHD, and I want to discuss them with you. It's basically, in general, an impairment in functioning in at least two settings, usually home and school, due to impulsivity, inattention, or hyperactivity. So let's discuss the three major types. We have the combined type, which is the most common. Patients with this problem have difficulty with attention and focus, and have some hyperactive or impulsive behavior. In the inattentive type, which is the second most common, they may have difficulty with attention, but there is no significant hyperactive or impulsive behaviors. And in the hyperactive impulsive type, which is less common, there's less problems with attention, and it's more common maybe in preschoolers, where they mostly have the hyperactive component. So there seems to be some genetic predisposition to this problem. Boys are much more likely than girls to get the problem. A child of a parent with ADHD has a 25% chance of developing ADHD themselves. Also, there is a 55 to 90% monozygotic twin concordance. In other words, there seems to be some strong genetics at work here. There are also some syndromes that are genetic that are predisposed to developing ADHD. Children with Klinefelter's, children with Turner's, children with Fragile X, children with neurofibromatosis type 1 or Williams syndrome or even DeGeorge syndrome are at increased risk for attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. So there are also, however, environmental factors at work. Patients with lower socioeconomic status are more prone to the problem, as are patients with parents who have mental disorders. Children in foster care are more likely to have ADHD. Children who were of low birth weight or prematurity are more likely to have ADHD, and children with acquired traumatic brain injury may develop ADHD. So ADHD may present differently depending on the age at which that child is being brought to attention. In the preschool era, hyperactivity is usually a larger component. These patients may be impulsive. They're not flexible with their environment. In other words, if something has significantly changed, they don't tolerate it very well. And they may be aggressive with their peers. In the elementary school era, these children now start to struggle with listening in class. They have poor organizational skills, they struggle with social interaction, and they may have difficulty functioning independently. And as adolescents, they have a problem with academic demands. As high school starts and these children have increased responsibility academically, they can really start to struggle. And they can start to struggle with attention, learning, and even executive functioning.